Hey, welcome back to the Board Game Closet. My name's Jimmy.
I'm Tim.
I'm Rod.
And today we're reviewing a game called Coconut. This was sent to us by Mayday Games, and we definitely appreciate it. And this is a game for up to four people and plays in roughly 20 minutes. So let's take a look and see what you get in the box. So this is what you get in Coconuts from Mayday Games. Rod, why don't you tell us about
Coconuts?
Mine.
That was mine, I swear. Oh.
I guess I'll go again.
All right, yeah. So the components. So you get these four little guys. You get these cardboard, what would you call these?
It's like a playmat or like a placard, tableau. Can we say tableau?
Each time you get your basket, you kind of pull them into here like this and make your own little pyramid of them. You get the coconuts, which look like chocolate covered peanuts, but that's
just I want
milk duds.
Every time, I was like,
it looks like a milk dud.
They're soft, so
makes me want chocolate.
Makes me a little hungry.
I'm gonna stop and get some chocolate.
And then you get the cards, and the cards are, you know, they're cards. So first of all, what I'll say about the pieces, I think they're pretty quality, quite honestly.
I really do.
This little guy right here, I mean, we were playing the other day, and. They seem to like they're gonna hold up just fine.
Especially for the audience, target audience of children.
Right.
You know, here, these are the very sturdy components.
The baskets, again, these pieces right here, I'm not so sure, but
just lay there. It's not like they actually, you don't pick those up.
But these cups are like really.
Yeah. So all in all, I would say quality of pieces are outstanding. Now, the other thing, just let me just throw this in there real quick. I'm not sure what age group we're talking about, but
I think six.
That's a choking hazard.
Yeah.
So be sure to count all these after you're done. Make sure you don't have any left around for little ones to, you know, swallow.
That's very true. All right, Tim, tell us about the instructions.
About these instructions. half of these are in another language. So you only have to worry about these right here. So it's really short. This basically is telling you, put it down like this, and then shoot the coconuts past the red line. That's it. These little cards, they have a description of what each one does. And it's pretty fun, actually, because each person gets two of them. And you can play them during your turn or somebody else's turn. And that's it. That's all the instructions need. But they have pictures and everything. So you can really tell what the components are. So good instructions.
So let me tell you how you play coconuts. It's really simple. It's just each person takes a turn, and you have to be behind this little red line, and then you launch your coconut, and you try to make it into a cup. If you make it into a cup, you get that cup, and then you put it on your little play area, and then you're trying. The goal of the game, whoever does this first, or when all the coconuts are gone, if you do this, then you win, or if all the coconuts are gone, whoever has the most. The only special rules is if you make it in a red cup, then you get to go twice. And that's the rules. Then there's cards that have to do with, like, one card says you have to do it blindfolded or with your eyes closed. One says you get to go twice. One says you have to do it an arm length away from the table. One says you have to choose which cup it's gonna go into, and it has to go into that cup. You get to go twice.
The blowing one, right?
Yeah, you get to blow on it. So when they launch it, you could try to blow it and make it
it's
not go in the
scary,
cup.
We just took that,
kid
we
is
took
doing
that
it.
One out. Cause,
we don't even use that rule. House rule.
Just spitting all over the place.
Yeah, get your six-year-old to start doing that. Yeah. So it plays really simple. It plays really quick. The box is 20 minutes, and I think it's totally that. It's 20 minutes at the most
that you would
go. So.
I'm just sinking them.
So I've got a four-year-old, and he played this game, and I know the instructions say six, but my four-year-old goes crazy over this game. Like, he's asked me 100 times, can we play the coconut game, Daddy? And he knows all the rules. He knows that if you get in the red cup, you get to go twice. And for me, it worked out great because he learns. My son's kind of in a middle stage, right, where he wants to play with the games. He thinks they're toys more than he thinks it's a game. And this is actually a perfect segue between that because he gets to play. It's dexterity, so he's getting to do something. But he also gets to learn that once you score, then you got to put it here, you get them up. And so he's won and he's lost because I'm ruthless. But so he learns the benefit, everything you get out of playing a game, you know. Yeah. So.
Well, we had my 10-year-old playing and he enjoyed it. He enjoyed it a lot, so... I mean, the question I have when we're rating this is, I think that each one of us has to ask ourselves, do we have fun playing it?
Mm-hmm.
I think that should tell you from there. I mean,
obviously, this is a child's game, you know, and we're not gonna rate it based on adults here. We're gonna rate it based on a child. You know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But I mean, even when we played it that day, even though it was so silly and stupid, it's still, I don't know, I still enjoy it. When I'm playing it with my kid, I'm like into it. You know, I'm like, I'm wanting to go from across the room, and there is a skill involved, right?
True.
Where you're trying to, you know, and you can master this thing.
Yeah.
Well, you change these to catapults and castles,
and
then you have, you know, fireballs going off into there. Yeah, pretty cool. Yeah.
And for adults, too, you know, you can line this up differently and have the cups spread out in different, you know, areas and stuff like that, and have different games set up. So you could set it into a party game easily.
Oh, yeah. So. I could see adults doing this at a party, like,
yeah.
Or even teenagers at the house, let's set it up. They would be so into this game.
Yeah, they would.
Okay. So at the end of our reviews, we like to give a one die rating. If we think you should green, go buy this game. White means maybe you wouldn't buy it, but you definitely play it. And then red means you wouldn't buy it and you wouldn't play it because you hate it. So let's all get our die that we're going to put out there. And reveal.
Three green. That doesn't happen very often. Yeah.
Not since Imperial Assault, right?
Exactly.
So Coconuts is in the same realm.
Exactly.
But anyway, so Tim, tell us why you gave it a green.
All right. So this game reminds me of, you know, when I was a child playing Mousetrap or Hungry Hippo,
that kind of
game. So I know that, you know, children, you know, will enjoy this game. And so if you have children, go ahead and buy it. Or if you're needing, like, just a silly game for your group, then this works out great. You know, like those other games like Rhino Hero or that Lupin Louie, I think is what it's called. Those kind of crazy games that adults also get into. This one kind of fits into that category, so...
Yeah, because a lot of times I have people come into my house and they see all these board games, and so they're looking for something that's different, right? They don't want to just play especially if they're gateway people and they're just trying to get into it. I don't know, something like this, even for adults, you pull this out and they're just gonna be, oh, this is funny, this is what you're all into, you know, you board gamers, you know, but it would be something different. So for me, I am looking for those unique things. And like I said, this is a total hit for my son. So whatever this costs, I'd buy it and add it to my collection.
Well, the thing that's amazing to me is I never would have even thought of touching this game.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and then they send it to us, and it was a blast. Yeah. I had a good time.
So much fun.
Like I said, my 10-year-old had a good time doing it.
Thanks for watching our review of Coconuts. We've got a lot more reviews on our website, boardgamecloset.com. We're also on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Is that all? I don't know. But anyway, please subscribe to our channel. We appreciate you watching. And as always,
support your local hobby shop or Board Game Cafe.
Oh,
a little change up there.